AWS really want people to migrate into their cloud, of course. So they have some great tool sets to help you to migrate into AWS, transfer your data, and cut over your applications. Now, this slide here just shows you a very broad picture view of some of the services, and we'll drill into a bit more detail shortly. On the right-hand side, we have a corporate data center. So here we have some servers, a database here, and some storage systems. Obviously, your data center is likely to be much more complex and have all sorts of different types of servers, some virtualized, some physical, different types of database, and different types of storage system. You might have file-based, block-based storage systems, maybe even an object-based storage system. Now, whatever you have, there's a way to get it across. In most circumstances, we're going to want to have a virtual private network, or even better, a direct connection, so that we have consistent network bandwidth between our data center and the cloud. And then there are some services that we can use to transfer and migrate our systems across. Now, at the top here, we've got the Migration Hub, which is simply the overall view that connects all these services together so that you can then manage your migrations. As you can see, for servers, there's a server migration service, and you can migrate your systems onto EC2. We've got the database migration service, which can help you to move your databases onto databases such as Amazon RDS, and DataSync for synchronizing your data from your on-premises storage systems into storage like Amazon S3 and EFS. So let's start off looking at the database migration service. So here we have some on-premises databases, Oracle and MySQL. Now, they could easily also be databases sitting on a server on EC2, or they could be RDS databases. So there's lots of flexibility in where your existing source database is. It's not just about migrating into AWS. You could be migrating from one type of database to another within AWS. So then we have the DMS service, and we can migrate across to a platform like Redshift in this example. Now, sometimes you're migrating between databases that are quite different. They have a different schema. And that means you can't just take the data from one and load it into the other database. You have to do some kind of conversion. And this is where the schema conversion tool can be useful. At the bottom here, we have DMS migrating a MySQL database to Aurora. And destinations could be not just Aurora, but Redshift or DynamoDB or DocumentDB as well. The next service I want to cover is SMS, the Server Migration Service. This will migrate your virtual machines and physical servers. They might be running on VMware, Microsoft, they could be Azure virtual machines, and you want to migrate them into Amazon EC2. So let's say you have your on-premises data center with your virtualized systems, some running on VMware, some on Hyper-V, and you install a connector. And that connector connects you through to SMS and then into EC2. And what happens is an Amazon machine image is created for each of your virtual machines or physical servers in your on-premises environment. Now, this is an automated process. It's incremental and scheduled as well. Once your on-premises servers are synchronized into an AMI, you can then launch EC2 instances from those AMIs. You can even use CloudWatch events and Lambda to automate certain actions as part of the migration. We then have AWS DataSync. So this is about synchronizing data between on-premises storage systems and the cloud. Your on-premises storage might be NAS servers running on NFS or SMB protocols. And then you take DataSync, and you have to use an agent, by the way, to connect to the storage system. And then you're able to synchronize your data into various backend storage systems on AWS, including S3, FSx, and the Amazon Elastic File System. Data is always encrypted with TLS, so that's encryption in transit. And again, you can schedule and automate your data transfers with DataSync as well. You can also install the DataSync agent on AWS Snowcone. Snowcone can then connect to DataSync and synchronize your data into S3. Now, what is the Snowball family? Well, these are physical devices that are used when you want to migrate very large quantities of data. And Snowball and Snowmobile are two of the different models. Now, you can see a little image here, and that is a physical Snowball device. Snowmobile is actually a truck with a container on the back, so it's for huge amounts of data. Now, we have a few different types of Snowball device. We have the Edge Compute Optimized, which provides block and object storage. This can be used for data collection, machine learning and processing, and edge use cases, so where you actually have some kind of requirement to perform compute and storage in an edge location somewhere where you might not even have regular connectivity to your data center. We've then got the storage optimized, which is again block storage and S3 compatible object storage. And this is used for local storage and large scale data transfer. So this is where you just want to move a large quantity of data. It's not about having any compute functions at the edge. Lastly, Snowcone is a small device used more for edge computing, storage, and data transfer. You can transfer data offline or online with the DataSync agent when using Snowcone. So a bit of general information. With the Snowball family, you're using secure storage devices for physical transportation. There's a Snowball client, which is software you install on a computer for identifying, compressing, and encrypting your data that you want to transfer. And it uses very strong encryption algorithms, so your data is very safe. And the next bit is very useful to remember for the exam. With Snowball and Snowball Edge, this is petabyte scale. That's wording you sometimes see coming up. Whereas with Snowmobile, it's exabyte scale because it really has that extra amount of volume. You can have huge amounts of data transferred with Snowmobile. That's it for now. I'll see you in the next lesson.